Good morning all of you. So today we'll discuss about the reciprocating compressor with clearance. Now we know that in the previous terminology we have defined the clearance volume, cert volume and other terms. So what is clearance volume? So clearance volume, it is the space between the top dead center and the cylinder head, whereas the cert volume, it is the volume of air compressed in between top dead center and bottom dead center. So accordingly the PV diagram is modified as, so it is A, B, C, D, and again here this is the clearance volume, that is indicated by VC, and this is what, this cert volume, that is VS, and this total volume is VA. So we can write this VA, volume VA, is the sum of clearance volume and the cert volume. Again, A to B is compression process, B to C is discharge process. Again here, C to D is expansion process, D to A is, again the expansion and compression represented here, it is polytropic. It depends on application. The compression may be isothermal compression, polytropic compression or adiabatic compression. Now the total mass remains constant, so that is mass at A and mass at B is equal, and similarly mass of air at D and mass of air at C is equal. So the net mass is the difference in MA and MD, or it is the difference in MB and MC. Again we can write the work required for compressor with clearance, that is indicated work, it is given as area ABCD, that is as previous. Again we can write this area ABCD as difference in area ABEF and area CEFD. Again for this area ABEF we can write the relation for indicated work as N upon N minus 1 MAR T2 minus T1, and for area CEFD we can write as N upon N minus 1 MDR T2 minus T1. Again taking this term common, that is N minus 1 R T2 minus T1, so we can write here this is N minus 1 R T2 minus T1 common, and we can write in this bracket MA minus MD. Again this MA minus MD is net mass M. So accordingly the expression is N upon N minus 1 MR T2 minus T1, where this M is the net mass. Now let us discuss about the next important term for specification of the compressor, which is free air delivery. So free air delivery, it is the amount of air handled or compressed by the compressor, or it is also defined the volumetric flow rate of air measured at free air conditions, that is P0 and T0. So accordingly this equation we can write from general gas equation, that is free air delivery is equal to P dot U is equal to M dot R T0 upon P0, where T0 and P0 is the condition of the air at the measured free air conditions. Now let us discuss about the volumetric efficiency. So it is the ratio of mass of gas entering to the mass of gas that should fill the cert volume at the same reference condition, that is at free air condition. So this is one definition. Second definition is volumetric efficiency is the gas entering measured at free air condition to the cert volume of the cylinder. It is given as VU by VS, or in terms of mass this eta V is given as MU upon MS. Now let us derive the expression for volumetric efficiency of the compressor considering the clearance volume. Again we know that volumetric efficiency is the ratio of Vu upon Vs. Again, we can write this Vu as Va minus Va. That is Va, this is Va, and Vd, this is Vd. So this difference is Vu, and Vs, it is Va minus Vs. So this Vs, this volume Vs is the difference of this total volume Va minus this clearance volume Vc. Again, we can substitute value of this Va as Vs plus Vc. Again, we can have PV raised to n is equal to C. So considering state C and state D, we can write this equation as PC Vc raised to n is equal to PD Vd raised to n. Again, taking Vc common in the numerator and Vs in the denominator, and by rearranging the term, we will get the expression for volumetric efficiency as 1 minus Vc by Vs in bracket P2 by P1 raised to 1 by n minus 1. Again, same derivation we will see in detail once again. Now, the same expression for volumetric efficiency we can see in detail here. It is volumetric efficiency, the ratio of Va minus Vd upon Vs. Again, we know that Va is equal to Vs plus Vc. Now substitute value of Va in the numerator. So we'll get it is Vs plus Vc minus Vd upon Vs. Again, we can separate the Vs term. So it is by separating that Vs term and considering again one more parameter, that is clearance factor C. So this clearance factor C is the ratio of Vc by Vs. So accordingly, we can write this expression as 1 plus C minus Vd by Vs. Again, by multiply and divide by Vc. So this expression is written in this form. Again, we can rearrange the term and we can substitute this C here. So accordingly, the expression for volumetric efficiency in terms of clearance factor we can write as 1 plus C minus C in bracket P2 by P1 raised to 1 by n minus 1. So this is the important relation for reciprocating compressor with clearance volume, that is for volumetric efficiency. Again, same expression we can rewrite considering again the relation between pressure and volume for polytropic process as PV raised to n is equal to C. So for state C and for state D, we can write this PC Vc raised to n minus is equal to PD Vd raised to n. And again, taking C common here, and we can write the modified expression for volumetric efficiency as 1 minus C in bracket P2 by P1 raised to 1 minus n minus 1. Now, let us discuss about the multistage reciprocating compressor. So, up till now, whatever we have discussed, it is the single stage reciprocating compressor considering clearance or without clearance. Now, let us discuss about the multistage compression with clearance. So, as per our syllabus, we have only introduction of multistage compressor. So, that's why we will see in brief about the multistage compressor. So what is multi-stage compressor? So we know that multi-cylinder engine. So in multi-cylinder engine, we use more than one cylinder. And that is used for our three-wheelers or for our four-wheelers or for commercial vehicles. So likewise, in multi-stage compressor, we have more than one cylinder. So mostly low pressure cylinder is referred as LP cylinder. High pressure cylinder is referred as HP cylinder. And intermediate cylinder is referred as IP cylinder. So LP, IP and HP, these are the cylinder designated in case of multi-stage compressor. Again, so this is the PV diagram for first stage, this is PV diagram for second stage, this is for third stage, and for three stage compressor this is the combined diagram. And again, we can derive the work required for single stage, second stage or more than two stage as previous. Now this is the diagram. Here this is the arrangement. So this is the low pressure cylinder, this is high pressure cylinder, and in between these two cylinder we have intercooler. If this is what two stage compressor, if it is three stage compressor, then here we have low pressure cylinder, this will be the intermediate pressure cylinder, and one more cylinder we have, and there will be two intercooler. So in case of two stage compressor we have one intercooler, in case of three stage compressor we have two intercooler in between the two cylinders. So what is the function of this intercooler? So it has a heat exchanger. So one fluid is what? It is the air flowing through the tube, and other fluid is the water. So water is circulated in this intercooler, and main function is to maintain the inlet condition always. Suppose this is the low pressure cylinder, air pressure at inlet is P1 and T1, and this is the exit pressure P2 T2. Now since it is the intercooler, so this exit pressure is referred as PI and TI, and so this intercooler is a device which is used to maintain the inlet condition at all the cylinders. So here this is the inlet condition, and this is the inlet condition for low pressure cylinder, this is the inlet condition for high pressure cylinder. So you can find here this condition or this pressure, and this pressure P1 T1 that is always maintained by using this intercooler. So accordingly this is the PV diagram for two stage compressor. Again this is the PV diagram for two stage compressor considering the intercooling effect. So due to intercooler we can save this work. So this section portion indicates that we can save this work due to use of intercooler in case of multistage compressor. Again this is indicated, and this is the TL diagram which indicates the effect of intercooling again. Now derivation for optimum intermediate pressure is very important, and that we can derive considering the total work during low stage, and that is low stage compression and high stage compression, or due to LP cylinder and due to HP cylinder. So accordingly we have the expression for the work similar to previous, as per the previous derivation, only considering the pressure as PI by P1 for first stage, and here P2 by P1 for the second stage. Again considering temperature TI is equal to T1, we can modify this expression and we can write in this way. Again since we have to find the optimum pressure, so we have to differentiate this total work with respect to pressure PI, and we have to equate to 0. So when we differentiate with respect to PI and when we equate to 0, and when we solve this expression, then we can write the intermediate pressure as PI square is equal to P2 into P1, or it is the product of P2 into P1, or we can write this is square root of P2 into P1, or we can write PI by P1 is equal to P2 by P1, or that is what our pressure ratio or optimum pressure ratio. Again the same expression we can generalize when we have more than one stage, if it is two stage, three stage or four stage compressor. So same expression is written in terms of two. So total work is Z into N upon N minus 1 MRT1 P2 by P1.